Not long after Lucia, one of your very favourite roles at the Royal Opera House Covent Garden, and one which I personally have a particularly strong feeling of love of the way that you did, which I felt you understood so greatly, Violetta in La Traviata.
Well, that was a really a favourite role of mine. I never perhaps looked particularly consumptive, but I loved the ensembles. I loved the big aria. I loved the finale. It was a real fantastic work, without the music, but with the music, and so splendidly matched. It was a wonderful piece to sing. Of course, all the coloratura was in the big opening aria, but it's a complex role, and underestimated none the least by myself, because I thought I knew it well and I didn't. To get up and sing it in a house the size of Covent Garden for the first time, after not that much study of it, and thinking, I know a lot of this, I really know a lot of this. It's not the same thing as doing it. And of course, I unfortunately, I think whether, half of it perhaps was caused by anticipation or anxiety, but I developed a terrible throat problem, and fool that I was, said, "Oh no, I must go on, I must go on," and it was crazy. I was out for 2 more weeks, but I loved it, and I did it a lot of times, and had some wonderful tenors with whom to sing it.
It is, if you just, as you've just said, of course, a famously complex role. It's been said that it needs three or four different voices, but I mean, in a sense, it's of course one voice doing three or four very different things in the different acts.
That's true. That is really true. It's nicely separated.
She is, of course, a woman who expresses, it seems to me, utter femininity. It seems to almost encapsulate everything about a woman.
Oh, definitely, definitely. She's a marvellous person. Marvellous person. No, the personality of Violetta is quite wonderful. And I think in some ways, this may sound strange to you and anybody else, but in some ways, like Norma.
Because of the conflicts and
That's right, that's right.
the complexity and the opposing forces within her, because
That's right.
she has got this tremendous strength. I mean, for heaven's sake, you know, that incredible moment in the second act when she gives Alfredo up is, there's no self-pity there. This is something that came across enormously in your performance, by the way. No self-pity.
No, none at all. It was the right thing to do.
I've chosen, Joan, something that I've for 43 years, ever since I first heard you sing this on a recording in this particular part, treasured, which is A Force et Lui. You capture the terrible illness of anticipation and fear, both emotionally and physically, and at the same time retain this wonderful, what I believe is how to sing Verdi, classical discipline.
Oh dear, you make me sound so, I don't know, uppity. I don't know. I mean, one studied the words always, and one studied the music, and you put the two together, and somehow they went. They don't always, but for me, it is a wonderful work from beginning to end, and so complex, as you have said.